Touchdown with Aaron Masemola. On the bench with local legends. Your questions, your heroes.
Welcome to the Touchdown with Aaron Masemola. And yes, it is yet another opportunity for us to chat all things rugby. Unfortunately, the Super Rugby Unlock series has now come to an end, and we now shift our focus to the Currie Cup. But joining me is a Toyota Cheetahs player. He plays in the lock position, and his name is Ian Groenewald. Ian, how are you doing?
I'm good, and yourself?
I'm doing very, very well. Thank you so much for joining us right here on the Touchdown. But looking at your journey, I would love for us to almost start at the beginning, where many South African fans actually got to know the name Ian Groenewald. And that was, of course, when you played in the Varsity Cup for Marties, and you also played two cup finals over there. I would love for us to just maybe touch on the importance of the Varsity Cup tournament, especially for the development of your career.
I think it's a great tournament, especially you get to study as well, which I think is very important. And it's a great stepping stone for a lot of great players that's playing Super Rugby and International Rugby and Currie Cup now at the moment. So I think it's an awesome initiative and a great stepping stone for a lot of guys, young players.
Definitely. You talk about a great stepping stone, and I mean, looking at your career, it's almost laid the foundation for you to move from semi-professional rugby to professional rugby as well. Now, we know that you've recently joined the Toyota Cheetahs, and you've started two games thus far already for the Toyota Cheetahs as well. I would love to find out from you, have you actually settled in at the Cheetahs yet, and how are you finding yourself in Bloom?
Yeah, I've settled in. Our house is all moved in now. My wife is here with me, so that's a plus. With the team, it's an awesome environment to be part of. Really, the guys are awesome, and everyone was very welcoming in the beginning and still welcoming. And obviously, like it is at every new place, you learn a lot in the beginning and you find your feet. But it's going very well, and really enjoying the time here in Bloemfontein so far. People are awesome as well.
Oh, very true. Now, the people in Bloom are absolutely lovely. The one important thing that you mentioned there is they've actually got your wife with you, which is so important in terms of moral support and in terms of just her being there to support you in your rugby career as well. But I also know that you got married during the lockdown period. Can you maybe just tell us a little bit more about your beautiful wedding, the ceremony, and how important it was for you to tie the knot with your wife?
Yeah, so we were... Obviously, this year has been crazy, for everyone. And our plan was initially to get married in December, now the 12th of December. Then lockdown happened and the rugby dates, everything was uncertain. And we had an off week, and I asked her if it would be possible for her to organize a wedding in 10 days. And yeah, she was keen on it. And yeah, she organized the awesome, I didn't do much, but... She organized everything she wanted at the wedding, and then next year we'll have a party for the people we're supposed to invite. So I told her this year was her wedding, next year is my wedding.
Oh, absolutely beautiful. I have to admit, you must have an absolutely amazing wife that can arrange a wedding in 10 days, because like looking at a wedding, that's probably one of the most difficult things to arrange as well. So well done to her in terms of that. But moving back to the rugby conversation, I mean, you've recently joined the Toyota Cheetahs, but one important thing to note is you didn't see faces that weren't too unfamiliar. I mean, when you look at a man like Harvey Svarie, a man that you spend some time with at Marties as well, how comforting was it for you as a player to move into an environment where it might be new, but you actually have a relationship with the coach?
It makes a big difference. It's really, he knows me and I know him, and he knows what to expect of me, and he knows how to get the best out of me. So having worked with him in the past makes a big, it's a comforting situations to walk into, and I mean, nothing is strange to you, and yeah, it's really a welcoming and awesome feeling to work with him again.
Definitely. You talk about it being comforting and also it just almost settling the nerves a little bit. And yeah. In terms of your journey with the Toyota Cheetahs already, we've seen you start two games already. That was against the Stormers as well as now this past weekend against the Griquas. How are you finding yourself in that lock position? And in terms of the guys around you in that forward pack, have you guys settled in nicely? And is there a strong bond between the Lions in the forward pack?
Yeah, I think the forward pack is... it's an awesome bunch of guys. It's always a special bond between the guys there. And Cornel, the forwards coach, also really helped in the beginning, just teaching me everything and what the systems are. And I knew from the beginning what was expected. So really, obviously, everything is new in the beginning and you feel like you're just running around. But yeah, it was a week now. I felt settled in, and obviously every week you're still learning new stuff and settling in more. But for now, yeah, it's been an awesome start so far with my journey of the Cheetahs.
Definitely. I think looking at the Currie Cup that now lies ahead, unfortunately the Super Rugby unlock is something that we can forget about, and we can now focus on the Currie Cup. And I'm certain you know how important the Currie Cup is to everybody across Central South Africa, and more specifically towards the Cheetahs fans. Looking at defending the Currie Cup going into the competition that starts for you next week Saturday on the 5th of December, when you take on the Bulls, who recently just won a trophy as well. Do you guys have a strong sense of confidence going into defending the Currie Cup?
Yeah, definitely. I think you have to take it game by game. Don't get too much ahead of yourself. So it's awesome. I think we're really excited to defend the title. And it's really excited for the tournament.
Definitely. I think looking at you as a new player in terms of the franchise, is there any specific message of support that you would like to send to the fans? Is there anything that you would like to communicate to the fans as well? Because we are so excited to have you a part of the Cheetahs.
Yeah, it's awesome being here in Bloem. Regtig 'n lekker plek, lekker mense. Ek het nog net goeie goed om te sê van Bloem, en is regtig baie verwelkomende omgewing gewees. Die Vrystaat is vir my baie mooi. Ek het regtig lief geraak vir die plek. So far it's an awesome experience, and yeah, just for them to keep on supporting, and we'll do our best on the field, and hopefully we can bring the trophy home again this year, and hopefully there can be crowds soon.
Definitely. We would love to pack that Toyota Stadium as soon as possible as well, just to make sure that we get behind the lads and we support you as well. But Ian Groenewald, thank you so much for joining me on the Touchdown. Welcome to Bloem. Welcome to the Toyota Cheetahs. And I think you will have a long and successful journey with the franchise. And of course, we look forward to you lifting the Currie Cup trophy very, very soon with the Toyota Cheetahs. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Aaron. Appreciate it.
Touchdown with Aaron Masemola. On the bench with local legends. OFM Sport, the personalities behind the plays.